Welcome back, everyone, to more Let's Play La-Mulana. Lameza obviously failed physics class because, I mean, look at him. He's sleeping in midair. That's not how physics work, man. Oh, yeah. Speaking of physics, you may notice that I have a different gold count, weight count, and shuriken count. Well, let me explain. There was a goofed recording of episode 2. And it didn't quite come out as I had intended, and yeah, I had to replay up to this point of the game again. So let's just play pretend that I didn't have to do that at all. Right now, we're going back up to the surface for two reasons. One, I am going to have to buy a piece of software. Two, I'm going to have to buy another piece of software. And three, I'm going to go this way. Hey look, it's a statue of Elder Zelpud, Mr. Baldy Bald Bald. That's gonna be his name, is Mr. Baldy Bald Bald. Yeah, whip that ass. Alright, and anywhom, if you whip this wall right here, we will get another piece of software. Death Village! Okay, that already sounds interesting. What is this? Nagoro's first Flash game. In this puzzler, you lead a man through a haunted house. Let us enter the world of survival horror and continue playing La-Mulana. They entered into the mansion, not knowing what nightmares would come forth. I haven't beaten Resident Evil multiple times or anything to know what Barry Burton's lines are. Yeah, you just learned something about me. I've only beaten the original Resident Evil once. On Chris's scenario, no, Jill's scenario, I beat the remake on Chris's, and that's about it. Why is a PC shop selling weights? And it's way too heavy for me. Okay, no. Nah, I think I'm pretty sure I could spend my money elsewhere. Oh, goodness. Yeah, I'd like to see you try. No, actually, that would be hilarious if she could literally, if you angered her enough, kill you. Like in Legend of Zelda Link's Awakening, how if you try stealing from the shop and if you succeed and then come back, the guy kills you instantly. I don't know why. Those two lines right here, whenever she says, "Oh, hell no, I'ma tear you apart," that makes me laugh my ass off, and so does the other one. So yeah, we have the Glyph Reader software and the Yagu Map software. So there we go. If you want to read what the little text is on the bottom, go for it. Yeah, now whenever we pause the game, we can see a villa, or, you know, we can see the map. And also, we can read some of the, what is it? Some of the things I couldn't read earlier. Like, I never read this one, but you don't need the Glyph Reader in order to read this. It's automatic. So let's actually try this out. Yeah, as you can see right there, I was playing a little bit ahead of time. Trying to record, actually, and I kind of just gave up on recording, so I was displaying the game just to play it. No, let's jump down here. What did I just tell you, Lameza? Stop being rebellious. Lameza, I will make you drop down there one way or another. Alright, here we go. Haha! And I didn't fall on my head and get the dream damage. That was an awkward accent that I probably will continue doing later. Alright, so now that we have the Glyph Reader, we can officially read this. This is where the mother lays to rest. In this path of trials, only heroes who do not fear death are permitted to proceed. Well, I'm not gonna lie, I'm pretty scared of death, so I should probably just go home right now, pack up my bags, just leave, and, you know, that's the end of this Let's Play right there. Well, yeah, you're sort of dead, man. I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but you're not getting out of here alive at all. The Pillar Gate, a room within the Gate of Guidance. So there's a name for each room. Yeah, you're already dead. Sorry. Yeah, we don't have the map for this place quite yet, but we're about to get it here shortly. Let's go on ahead and read this. Behold, the Gate of Guidance. Death awaits those who would disturb this land. Well, I'm kind of disturbing it by killing skeletons, amongst other things, so I don't know, maybe Lameza is going to die. Who am I kidding? It's La-Mulana. I'm definitely going to die multiple times. You will probably laugh at the failure that is sure to ensue within this game. Let's see here. I haven't read you. Those who challenge the Guardian know thy strength. Death awaits the powerless. The future awaits those who train themselves and take on the challenge. Yeah, if you notice, there's a little symbol right here on this wall. Keep that in mind for later, because we're going to be coming back to it. If I told you to memorize everything in La-Mulana that you had to, you'd probably have an aneurysm. Well, let's go ahead and get the map. Look at that. So now we're in the Heavenly Corridor. Huh, sounds cool. Hiya! Take that, Antlion. You don't belong in this world. Let's go ahead and push this over here, which activates that, which we will come to later. All right. Murdering more Antlions and getting more gold in the process. Whoa. Now, for this room right here, all you have to do is, well, before I go ahead and spoil it, it shall connect once held in the mouth. When one swallows, the other spits out. Well, that thing has got something held in its mouth, and I just lost money. So if you hit it 3 times, it kind of swallows it, and it starts choking, so you have to perform the Heimlich maneuver on it. Two brave souls. Quiet solitude. A rock that reaches a high place. What is the brave soul? It's our mother. I don't think the mother is the brave soul. I think the mother is the murderous rampager at the moment. We're after the secret of life. The mother's kind of gone a little bit insane. Come on. There we go. It seems there are shops in these ruins. Oh, well, I'm about to die, so it doesn't matter to me. Oh, sometimes I love the text in this game. It is funny. Let's see. Let's go ahead and place a weight on there, so that way I don't have to later. Yeah, I'm just gonna have to ride this elevator. Actually, no, we have to come back to that room, so I'll examine that room up there in the top left corner whenever I have to come back. Alright, even though I have played through this game a couple of times, I don't have everything pat down memorized, so you're gonna have to forgive me, viewers. Alright, you know what? I really, really want to read this tablet. To those who push the white box, the white platform and the white box are drawn to each other. So, yeah, that's a hint as to we must push white boxes onto white platforms. Well, actually, that's not even a that's not even a hint. That's just straight out telling you, hey, do this. The guild runs a hidden shop. Put something aside in favor of money and barter. Okay, yeah. Let's put a weight right here. Enter here. And enter here. Well, we're running pretty low on weights. I want to buy this, which is guild, and it detects hidden stores via sound. Well, I don't have the money, and I need more weights, so I'll take one of those. Whoa, suicide rats! No, you have so much to live for, like me whipping you and taking a shuriken. The sad tale of the giants. The tragic history of the giants is written here. Yeah, I didn't see it written right there, so I guess it must mean that it's on down that ladder. I feel kind of special right now, like the short bus special, just because I don't know. Well, there was nothing written there. Let's see if you say anything. The first age of the sun was destroyed by flood. The second age of the sun was destroyed by the god of wind. Third age, god of fire. Fourth age, blood and fire falling from the sky. Alright, so remember the order. Flood, wind, fire, blood, and fire. Hiya! No, I said hiya. Don't explode. Alright, let's go ahead and grab that. Oh, wait. Does that guy say anything? I figured out where the Cliff of Radiance is, but there's some sort of door blocking my way. Pulling doesn't open it, actually. There isn't even a doorknob to pull. Huh, how ironic. Yeah, you'll never know, but thank you for informing me. Alright, so remember that order. I told you water, wind, fire, blood, and fire. If you remembered, congratulations, you get a good job sticker. If you didn't remember, I'm sorry, but you don't. You have to destroy these in the right order. If you fail, that eyeball up there will... let me just put it this way. That eyeball up there will make you have a bad day. If you think that you're having a pretty crappy day, viewers, just wait until you get struck by lightning bolts. Go ahead and climb up here. Put a weight on that. And I heard something click in the right side of the screen. The only reason why I heard it, though, is because I'm wearing headphones. If you didn't hear it, viewers, then, well, that's probably normal. Yes, I like having money. Something that I don't have at the moment. Oh, well. I get paid eventually. Hey, look at that. We got an email from Elder Zelpa. Let's read it. Oh, yeah, and also the emails are kind of out of order from last time. Modern doors. Okay. Yeah, if you can't tell what direction that is pointing, just look at that little black arrow in the middle of it. So now we can't push it the other way. Well, I'm pretty sure if we pulled hard enough, well, that still wouldn't work. Yeah, you see this right here? Don't whip it. If you whip it, that's going to end... it's going to end up with you on the ground in pain. Alright, let's see here. Aha! I am victorious! Aw, you didn't give me money. How dare you? It's my birthday! Actually, it's not my birthday. A watchtower soars above the Temple of the Sun. Traps to capture thieves have been newly set in a newly constructed wall to the key. Okay. Wait a second, did it just say the key? What? Okay, yeah, the key has been hidden. I thought I said Keyblade for a second there, and I was thinking, wait, what's Kingdom Hearts doing with this? We get the Ankh Jewel. And I'm going to open up my laptop while I'm on a ladder. Absolutely. If you use them in front of those cross-like thingies called Ankhs, located here and there in the ruins, you can break the Ankhs. Breaking them will make something bad happen, so maybe think about going back to the village to save first. And while you're there, why not chat with me? Well, because eventually you start repeating yourself. Aha! And in order to kill this guy, this is all you have to do. Just stand at the top of the ladder right there and whip him. And he can't hit you. That's always a good thing. You know what? I'd rather not whip that open right now, just because. Oh yeah, and also upon defeating those two red skeletons, yeah, that happens to fall. And that bat tries to kill your face. Aw, why didn't you give me money? How dare you? There we go. Alright, let's push that right there. Oh, ha ha ha! I killed a bat! I did not see that coming. Hey! Those bats were just giving me money. Like, just holy crud. Pour thy memories into the Holy Grail. Leave thy mark on this land. Then raise the Holy Grail up and recall lands once traveled. Alright, well... I don't know about you, but it sounds to me like that's what the kids today call warping. Warping, teleporting. Yeah, same difference. There we go. Let's climb up here and jump on top of this. And push it. This block puzzle is simple enough, even a fifth grader could solve it. As for Jeff Foxworthy, not so much. I've never understood why he created the TV show, or... I'm not sure if he created it or if he just hosted it, but are you smarter than a fifth grader? There we go. That just sunk down there. Let's see what this guy has to say. He found an escape route! These ruins seem to be connected in a very mysterious fashion. But, what do you mean he found an escape... Hello? Well, that's not normal! So I wait, what? So I went from... Okay... I'm not gonna question your logic, No, push it down. Oh, come on, that should've killed the bat. There we go. Now we have opened up this treasure chest, and we are going to get the most important item in the game. The Holy Grail. You may be wondering, why is the Holy Grail so important, Steve? Well... It's required to beat the game, first of all, and second of all, it lets you teleport from place to place, so if you ever get trapped somewhere, hey, you can teleport yourself out. Otherwise, you're stuck and have to reset. Yes, they call it warping. I'm the one who said that. Only because I knew that that's what you were going to say. Alright, so that hole that's right beneath me, over here, don't jump down there. That's probably not your brightest idea, but in order to warp, this is all you have to do. And in order to actually teleport to the Grail Tablet right here, you have to first read it, which is why I went out of my way to read it like this. So, viewers, that's it for this episode of Let's Play La-Mulana. Join me next time, and chances are, we're gonna see some snakes.